if we're not actually working yet because Tommy isn't here. And
here we go.
Okay, Mark, I'm going to ask you because you're closer to a fan than a host.
No,
right
we're
now,
recording.
But I know, but we can cut it out because I need to ask a question. What do you think the fan special should actually be like? What, as a fan, what would be exciting for you to come on here and talk about?
You want to ask
like with everybody here?
Because
there's going to be
that's a good question.
I think we have either four or five guests that are from the Discord. It's only Discord guests.
Yeah, I would ask Paul Timer, but he'll never show up. And
yeah, I'll have you know right now that I permanently muted the FireArt channel. Because it kept pinging for me, and I'm like, I have nothing. I have literally nothing. Every other channel is open
just,
for me.
You just drop pictures of Uncle Little in there. You're like,
but did I send that picture of him pointing the gun at the camera?
You sent it to me, and you were like, here you go. Haunt your nightmares.
I'm going to go control with your murder stick.
All right.
Mark, what about like a live Q&A? What if you guys all just like ask us questions?
Do you want that to happen?
Yes.
I'm totally
I think we're the well-behaved ones.
To be fair, I would say at the beginning, like before we start, there'd be like a disclaimer that this is going to be recorded. It is going to be released as a public show, and it is going to end up being edited.
And
however, Tommy has never edited us wrong yet, so I don't think he'd go in there
all.
And... Oh, he has. After what he did on that Pink Williams episode, fuck it, he gets it.
And then he fucking hit it as an intro.
I didn't know.
Anyway.
More he definitely didn't admit to it when we were streaming one night either.
Also, the disclaimer is going to be I'm not liable for anything I'm going to say to a fan during the recording. If I make you cry, I'm sorry. I have a lot of pent up
rage
and aggression.
Nelson is definitely Joker momenting somebody.
I don't know. It depends. Sometimes it pops off in here, and sometimes it doesn't. It really just depends. I don't know. I can think about it. Because, I mean, it's not going to be like until...
We only
Mark,
got...
Mark that head shake you did when you did it with that was the sassiest fucking thing ever. You're like, I think about it.
What? No, I was just looking at my phone.
You were like...
That's just because
I'll think about it. I am the number one fan, I know. I'll think about it. Yes.
I'll think about it.
Fuck all the peasants in the Discord. I am the number one fan.
The more that I'm referred to as a fan, the less I like it. maybe the word listener should be used.
No, fan. With two N's. I don't know if that changes it. I can't spell, and I don't know what words mean. There
one
you go.
One of those things you can't say. Neither of you.
Cool.
Well, this is fun.
This has been great, y'all. All right. Thanks for tuning in, y'all. It's a great episode. Bye. Look away, look away, look away, Dixieland. Kyle, you gotta say it.
Whoa, shut that bitch up.
All right, here we go. All right, y'all, thank you for tuning in to Dixieland and the Proletariat. We're gonna talk about Southern working class history and whatever the fuck this episode is about through a leftist perspective. Make sure to like us on social media at Dixieland and the Proletariat or find our links on our Linktree at Linktree/DixiePro, where if you wanna give your wages to a bunch of rednecks, you can find the link to our Patreon. We got a lot of cool stuff to give you, including CDs, stickers, a cookbook, Discord server, Twitch stream, and exclusive episodes. We also have a Spotify playlist with some great artists you also check out, as well as our merch store. This podcast is brought to you by Contraction Monogamy Therapy, Vaping, Living at Home, Modelo, Kaiser Pushing White Men in the Swamps, Tommy's Herbal Clinic, Nelson's Love Life, Tyler's Wild Stories, and of course, Beans Rise, Jesus Christ, and Byron. Shout out to our new Patreon subscribers, Josephus, The Tanky, Storm McCullen, Dawson, Big Fucking T-Slur, The Coldliest Family, Top Bunk Wanker, Revolutionary Garden, Alfred, and the best name of any Patreon subscriber, Nelson is my favorite host. Our monthly Patreon surplus goes to groups that are run by and help marginalized people directly. As always,
that name sucks.
As always, I'm Nelson, wondering why I'm fucking here. And with, yeah, just go
on. Lend somebody in. I didn't even know you were starting, by the way.
Oh, you hit fucking record, so it starts.
Into it. Yeah, well, not really.
Oh, my God. Zoom user.
Oh, shit. A government agent.
Who fucking sent the link to a random?
The feds are here. Oh, shit.
Everyone hurry and turn their cameras off.
Nah, I want you to know it's me. Look at my face.
Is this going to be Black Red Guard?
We should have invited
Chris.
Fear
in Tyler's eyes.
Chris would shit. Chris would make Tyler shit himself.
Who is Zoom user? Show yourself.
Who is Zoom user?
Show yourself, Zoom user.
Yeah.
It's me.
God, is that you?
That was Herman Cain? So ominous.
It's Herman Cain.
My name is Ian, and I do not know why it doesn't show my name here.
Well, Ian, you're coming across very serial killer-like, so I don't know what the fuck is going on.
Fucking starting off great.
I know who it is, because I know everyone's name.
Well, hey, Mark. All right, anyway, so...
I'll keep your secret, don't worry.
I'm me. Who else is here? It's a clusterfuck anyway.
Ian, apparently. Who the fuck that is? Well, fuck it, I'm Ian,
I'm Rain. I'm Rain Dog on the server.
Oh, my arch nemesis.
Oh,
other Louisiana. Yeah.
Oh God. Here we go.
A Tom Waits fan has entered the chat.
Anyway, so I'm going to go ahead and load it.
you know, you're missing like a good portion of the co-hosts. Like you're missing my favorite co-host, Kai. You know. Yeah. We have Tommy in here, and he always keeps it down low, and he keeps it great. I love you, Tommy.
Thank you, Zoom user.
But then I'm sitting here, staring at this disgusting, fat, olive oil lactating cheese monkey.
Strike one. Look,
along
it's
with
the
his, along with his friend, the depressive dog.
Strike one.
No, Zoom. No, nothing. Just straight right on in, Rob.
Strike one. We're not even like 3 minutes in. I've already loaded the case.
We didn't
one.
Even buy him dinner Where? First. Shit.
So who else is here? Introduce yourselves, our loyal fans.
I'm Trey. I'm the other guy from Louisiana. The less cool one, I think.
Okay. I'm Ryan. And I'm from Texas. So... Yeah.
Glad y'all are giving out your government names and locations. Thanks, y'all.
Yeah, you know, we now
Marty
know
on the
exactly
list, baby.
I'm Andy, and I'm also from Texas.
Yay.
Hey, hi, you know. Andy. You know, we're going to do that one.
Sister Andy's here.
I'm Kat. I'm from Western North Carolina.
Kat can beat up anyone here. I put money on that.
Mm. Hell yeah.
I'll cry while I
believe
do
that.
All right, Mark, my son.
Hi. The more like, I thought about the other day, and I think it is a little weird if I called you dad. That's a little close to some weird stuff. So
you know that's a fucking bizarre dynamic.
Turns out it can get more uncomfortable in here.
Bless me, cornbread, call me father.
No.
Yeah, Father Tommy.
I will never fuck
Father Hatch. Father Tommy.
Yeah, you know.
No. Yeah, we thought about
Tommy
it the other day. Tommy
becomes
actually
a priest.
Tommy actually went to Catholic school longer than I did. So Tommy has the most Catholic education.
Anyway,
really.
Anyway, so why we're here? Why are we here? Okay.
Why are we here?
To drive Nelson to the brink.
Yes, that is one of the goals. That is primary objective.
Yeah, so probably now strike everyone one can shit talk. So now that everyone can shit talk Nelson to his face.
Exactly. Already strike one.
A bigoted rant about the Irish folks.
I was thinking about that the other day. I got to think of more stuff. Did I tell you guys about the Cabbage Patch Kids? I told you all about the Cabbage Patch Kids shit, right? And why the why the potato famine is an actual genocide? Because it has nothing to do with potatoes.
No.
So the Irish genocide, it's a genocide. It doesn't have nothing to fucking do with potatoes, right? Irish children come out of the ground like Cabbage Patch Kids. And so, but they're called potatoes. So what actually it was is potatoes didn't get killed by blight. The children did because they couldn't grow. So that's why it's a genocide, because technically, I guess they're quote unquote people. So, you know, that's
really hardcore, like fighting back the urge to burp right now.
Yeah, like, no, it's right in the middle of
between. Oh my God, I'm holding back a mask. I always got a shit too, so I'm already holding it back.
That's
the Irish are on that thin line.
Very
of thin whiteness.
I don't know. I've done enough research on Boston to realize they're just as fucking racist as everyone else.
Yeah, you know, it's if Boston is the blueprint we're going off of, yeah, fuck them. Sorry, I'm sorry, fucking Paul.
Listen, I can't speak for all the Irish Americans in general, but I will say that my father's side of the family, the Scotch-Irish, were not great people.
All I had to say was Scotch Irish. That's like
the problem. Yeah, the people they sent over specifically to get away with
No. Mine were one of the first families to come over here in the late 1600s, late 1700s.
The original colonizers.
They were the original colonizers. Yeah. They were not good people. They were terrible. And my dad was weirdly proud about it. It was strange.
Is this how it feels to be in one of those DSA meetings? Because I've never been to one, but it feels pretty, you know.
Pretty close.
No, it's more experience. It's more cringe because there's like a stack.
This is a DSA meeting, I'm out.
Yeah, you know, this particular podcast is basically the It's Always Sunny of lefty podcasts.
Fair.
You know what? I take that as high praise.
Yeah, that's
that is what I strive to be.
I've been videoing grid view, and it's like a fucked up Brady Bunch.
It is.
I had to put it in there because I didn't like not seeing everyone's faces.
Okay. All right. So before Nelson rudely interrupted me because he's racist, we're all here because, you know, we always do this annual thing where, you know, we talk about what the next season is going to be.
We do.
But yes, we're just never a part of it. But this year, we have decided to put season 3 into the fate of our loyal fans. So that's where you guys come in. So
with some asterisks. One, it's going to be completely over ham radio.
Never.
We'll give you out a frequency and you're going to listen to it, and it's not going to be recorded. It's going to be live over ham radio.
It's my childhood.
Well, anyway.
Yeah, you know, are you trying to unionize the fucking truckers?
Okay, so first question to all of you. Okay, was season 2 better than season 1?
I don't even remember.
Yes, I think.
Okay.
When did Kai come on?
When did season one end?
I was gonna say where are the defining lines?
What's the
defining
line? I
thought we've been doing this for 3 years already.
Yeah, yeah. Every December is a season. So we started in December, right?
We started in October.
Yeah, same thing.
We started in August.
I didn't get there until December, it didn't start until December.
It started October 2019.
It didn't start until
after you. Yeah, no, I think the current incarnation of the show really started when you kicked off the other co-host for being anti-Semitic.
That's what happened?
That's not what happened. That is not what happened. Oh, God. For the record, that is not what happened. Okay, we're not going to talk about
that. They were annoying.
It's not, that.
Will did say the case slur on the second episode.
Yeah, but, that's yes.
But he was quoting an Onion article.
Oh, that makes it better.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Yeah. So many cats and so many bags are being let out.
Nelson's sweating.
I don't care anymore.
Do you think they listen to this shit?
If I say I'm just quoting a screwdriver song, is it okay?
Yes. The only time it's okay to screwdriver is when you drunkenly slur your words before you hit a fucking tree. That's the only time.
Emphasis. In Nelson's case, emphasis on the slur.
Exactly.
So I agree. When Kai came on, it became a much, much better show.
100%.
So and obviously when I came on, that's when it started. Yeah. So
yeah. I don't think anybody can like tie everybody together and keep them like on the right track.
Yeah.
A continuous line of conversation.
Yes. See, I try. Thank you. Thank you.
I mean, the residential school app was just like, that was some of the best work y'all have done. And I mean, yeah, mm-hmm. it was a lot of it is really dark and hard to process. But I mean, y'all managed to bring that in a palatable context where, like, you know, it's not, I want to kill myself at the end of it. Like,
I want to kill myself at the end of every episode we do.
I think because this is my hell.
Today's the day.
I think there's something to be said about what you just said. I'm going to call you Louisiana because that's just what I know you in the Discord. Is that okay? Or should I call you Trey?
Yeah, no, that's fine. Go ahead. Whatever you want.
But I think there's something to be said about that and something that really made me, I think, like the show a lot and really become, I think, more interested to the level that I am now was the fact that it's like, hey, there's just a bunch of white dudes on this podcast. And then there became some topics that were not appropriate for y'all to talk about. And instead of trying to talk about it anyways, it was like, mm-hmm. hey, let's just collectively shut the fuck up and have somebody here that knows how to talk about this appropriately. And and I think that it's like, that's such a simple move. It's just such a fucking simple thing to do. But like, you know, for some reason, a lot of people don't do that. So
I know we sacrifice money for respect. I understand. You know, it could have been Chapo Trap House making millions of dollars. Three white guys. Yeah, it could have been.
I think a good example of that. A good example of that would be the Kellogg episode.
No one listened to that episode.
Hold on. That episode's hardcore.
No, which one was the Kellogg episode?
The Kellogg episode was the one by the end of it. I understand why Tommy disassociates halfway through our episodes all the time. It's because by the end of that, I was just completely out of it. I wanted to start playing Xbox.
That's the only episode my husband has listened to. So I think we like de-radicalized him.
Okay. He's like, okay, wait, never mind.
The Kellogg episode was gold. Fuck anybody who disagrees. Tommy delivered that perfectly.
The episode a lot. I was a huge fan of it, but you know, Nelson basically shadow banned me. He dropped another episode on top of my episode, so he just like,
what episode was after that?
Another way the white man is just trying to hold the black man.
That's exactly it. That's the point of the podcast.
You know, let me check.
I don't know if anybody has their favorite episode, but you don't have to say it or not. This isn't a love fest because shit's about to get real in a second. But I will say, Sicko Mode is probably
that was the one right after Kellogg. Yeah. That was my favorite one. Yeah, like funny, like just I cried laughing.
Yeah,
I go back and listen to that one because it's so fucking funny.
Yeah, Sicko Mode really delivered.
Okay, so never mind. No one cares, Nelson. So. My next question to you all is, okay, what would you all change? What would you all add or change to the show if you could?
And if one of you motherfuckers says, take me off, I'm deleting the fucking podcast. I already know what the fuck you're
okay, so
say.
Besides removing Nelson, which I know
I control the money and I control all the fucking uploads and shit, okay? I'll take it down. I'll end this hell that I'm stuck
in. Jesus Christ, Nelson.
Fucking hell.
Take it down. Take it down or not, Nelson.
I'm not fucking taking it down.
Here, no, we haven't gone into your love.
Take Alexapro.
Calm down.
I'm gonna grab the shotgun here in a second. You're gonna get a
real fucking. My trust in you is like steadily declining.
Popping out. Yeah,
no, we
Nelson completely just offs himself. I have a genuine, like, honest question. So, like, as far as suggestions are concerned, are you any suggestions that specifically like would pertain to like working class South?
Okay.
Maybe. Yes. No. Okay. So. I would like, because for personal reasons, more of the gay, more of the LGBTQ, that would be super rad. But also because it's one thing that I feel really impacts all of America, honestly, but seriously impacts rural areas in the South is nutrition. It's a big like thing of mine.
Okay. Well, I can tell you
right
now. Oh, I'm cool with everything. We're not talking about nutrition because look at us. That's not.
Listen, yeah, listen. Hey, I don't mean that fucking organic non-GMO bullshit. Okay. That shit can eat my fucking
struck a nerve.
No, I fucking hate that shit. I hate that fucking white gentrified fucking nutrition bullshit about how you just need to eat grass-fed fucking beef all the goddamn time. Fuck that shit. All right.
Well, grass-fed beef is so good.
Grass-fed beef.
Yeah, it's also
really
super fucking expensive and super fucking out of reach for most poor people.
It is.
But it's pretty easy to steal from Whole Foods.
You're not wrong.
It's not easy to steal from a Whole Foods if you don't have one.
Oh, he's got shooting on.
Any Walmart self-checkout. It's always bananas.
Yeah, Walmart. Walmart does
bananas.
You can always buy a hog, raise it, and then get a ballpoint hammer.
I've
got $5 generals and a Piggly Wiggly. That's all I got on the
table. Did you say a ballpoint hammer?
There's a town, just like a couple towns over from me, where they are so small, their only like grocery store they had was a Piggly Wiggly, which was about to close out, like completely go out. And the townsfolk like gathered up money. They got enough money together to keep this fucking Piggly Wiggly open so that they could keep a grocery store, wouldn't have to drive like 50 fucking thousand miles to go get some bread and milk.
That's what J.D. Vance should have written about and not his fucking bullshit.
Fuck J.D.
experience.
Vance. He can eat my ass too.
That's the real hillbilly, whatever the fuck it is.
J.D.
I spent a summer in Appalachia, so I know everything Vance can fight me.
There are more topics I'd like to hear, like maybe some more rural stuff, but I actually really like the format because if I wanted to hear a bunch of put together boring white guys talk for 2 hours, I could go listen to every other leftist podcast,
right?
Okay. But I need, well,
I like that
I
it's a little
guys
unhinged.
To like fall apart a little.
A little.
Yeah.
before I agree. Kai's like, here's a depressing factoid.
Yeah. 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 Well, you know, I agree with that. I like that. And that was another question I was going to ask after this, but we'll let everybody talk for a second. Mark, do you have any suggestions? You've actually been on the show and unfortunately and have ruined many of shows that we cannot air. But
you were there for the Bill Cosby incident.
I was.
No.
I know all your secrets.
No.
So
what the fuck did you motherfuckers do?
How about this for a podcast idea? I go like off the rails and write like every single thing I've heard.
No? I mean, yeah. Yeah. Mark tells it all. The
Mark exposes the podcast.
Yeah, behind. We need a Mark episode. We need a Mark Spills
the
Beans episode.
VH1 behind the
I'm
podcast.
I'm secretly a drama YouTube channel and I'm just collecting
intel.
Can you
please
a hashtag on Twitter of cancel Dixie Prol?
please.
Yeah, so no,
the next Patreon's here.
Yeah, Mark has the exact number of of censored things that Tyler has said. He knows them all, and he's going to release them.
That's the next Patreon tier. Is just Mark sends you one quote a day. No
Mark
content.
Sends you
Mark,
a quote.
Mark doesn't
I bother
have,
you. That's the next Patreon.
Mark doesn't have the audio files.
I have some emails.
Saved.
I have one.
Actually, Mark gets a lot. So I run a lot of stuff through Mark.
Shut up, no. Nelson.
Yeah. I'm the HR department. I guess.
I do
Mark,
have a real
Mark
suggestion.
Is my HR. I got to be sure that All this shit is up to snuff.
We had an HR department. We shut down.
I do have a real suggestion. Tyler, this one is for you. I signed up for the Patreon and started giving y'all money right after you stopped mailing out redneck shit. And I know probably puts a lot of pressure on you. I get it. But I'm a little disappointed in the lack of redneck shit that came in the mail to my house. So, yeah.
Yeah, I just got Nelson CD.
Ryan, I'll send you something. I can't.
Yeah, all I got was Nelson CD.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, You listen to it and it's just like, is this the recording of his colonoscopy?
Okay, I'm going to give Nelson this one because there are two songs from that CD that are all my most played on Spotify this year.
No fucking way. No. That is bullshit.
I'm a screenshot.
What songs? Because I know Nelson's entire catalog. I've been waiting to hear it.
Yes, yeah. I've been to a lot of Nelson shows.
I think Dead Horse is one of them.
Yeah, I really like that song.
Yeah, the full band version turned out really well. I'm not going to lie.
Shit. Fucking hell.
Is it on the CD or is it on... Is it on the CD or is it on Spotify?
I think both are on the CD. I'll be honest. I'm not 100% sure because at the time when you sent it to me, my car radio went kaput and I wasn't able to actually listen to it, which made me
sad. I guess I got to find a CD player now.
Nah.
You can use it. Mark said he uses it as a coaster, so y'all can use it as a coaster.
I was literally thinking of a time to insert that joke, and I hate that.
Fuck you.
Nelson
should do a follow-up to the Rahm Emanuel song with Chicago's current governor. the fat lady.
I'm missing a bullet.
Lightfoot.
Nelson, you should do a follow-up to Rahm Emanuel.
The lady with the widest eyes.
I would also like to hear more stories of Tyler almost killing himself while powerlifting because related.
Oh, let me tell you, I've fucked my back up twice this month.
Yeah.
Same.
Yes.
And I've heard very specific rumors that he may have injected trembolone into his dick too, but at one point. But I don't know.
No, that is not the case yet, but God, I'm so close to steroids.
That's weak shit.
So close.
But no, you're not on point. Don't use juice.
Nelson is over here fucking around with his gun.
I lost a bullet. These things are fucking expensive.
What? Oh, God. Anyway.
Nelson, don't be like my high school bully and accidentally shoot yourself.
He is.
No one accidentally does that. I just brought this.
All right.
You just shoot yourself three times in the head.
Gary Webb.
Getting on to something that I liked. Like, okay, so y'all, you know, a lot more Southern stuff. This is going to be a little bit out of the blue, but like the interviews y'all could do. I mean, there are just so many people out there that I think would love to have a platform to talk to, and especially a Southern platform, especially a Southern pro queer, pro BIPOC, all that stuff. Like, that is like a big deal for people. And like, my first suggestion would be there are a couple of Southern drag queens I would love to hear be interviewed.
Fuck,
I think that would be a lot of fun.
We have had some very rough fucking guests this past.
We actually banned guests. We're not having guests anymore.
So that brings us. Well, that's what I was going to ask. That brings us to my next question. So I know, you know, try to keep it unhinged, you know, have more LGBTQ presence on the show, which that's something we have been discussing internally. So that is something that we do plan to do very soon, is have a more LGBTQ presence on the show. So, but yeah, that's one thing I wanted to ask you guys. So there are a lot of episodes that you guys have not heard that have not aired.
It's not my fault.
And that's because
mostly
there's like one, I was there one for full one, ep- so one full episode and a bunch of edited out clips of other episodes.
And so that puts us in a really weird position as to, like, we don't want to look like we're supporting what they're saying. Do we edit it out to make them look good, or do we leave it in? And then we end up looking, I don't know. We've internally struggled with this a lot. And we've had guests come on. Now, granted, we really aren't doing our part by doing pre-show interviews, which is something that we have stated that we need to do, but we haven't done. And with the schedules that we have, it's kind of hard to do to get us all on at once. We can really only do it on Mondays. And so doing pre-show interviews are kind of not feasible unless we plan it so far out. Yes, Ryan.
So I'm sure that I don't want to like pretend like this isn't something you guys have already like thought about or talked about, but it's like, as far as doing pre-show interviews, I understand not being able to all get on, you know, to do a pre-show interview, but what if you had a sort of a like predefined, like I guess list of interview questions or something. I don't know. It wouldn't need to be questions necessarily, but like pre-interview discussion topics or something like that. And like one of you could do a pre-interview, you know, or a pre-show interview or whatever. And then kind of like talk to everybody else about it and be like, this is what, you know, this is how that went. What do we all think? You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah. That's a good idea.
Cause that could happen. Especially if it was like a predefined, like I said, a predefined list of questions or topics or whatever to discuss, then it wouldn't be like one person going up to everybody else and being like, yeah, I like their vibes. But it's like, cause that doesn't mean anything. That could go south, you know? But if it's like, hey, we talked about this. Yeah, exactly. So we talked about this and this is how they responded to that, you know? And it's like, everybody can have like a concrete thing to base their opinion off of about whether or not they should be on.
That's a good idea.
The thing is like our platform, like it runs loose so much during shows that it just gives some people the opportunity to show a side that we didn't realize before.
That's also true.
Yeah.
And they'll go off and say some like super wild, offensive to like one of our marginalized hosts you know, if that makes sense.
Shit on me, shit on us, a racist.
But when you say some like very insensitive shit towards like an indigenous person, or you try to like talk over and completely like silence like a black person, like I mean, it's just at that point it's hard to deal with.
Yeah,
I thought the episode with the gynecologist was really good, but maybe that's because she was talking about her job and not her personal opinion, you know?
Yeah, now we've had, that's not saying that we haven't had good guests, and a lot of the ones that we want to keep, you know, keep recurring, like past show hosts, like of course Chris Redgard, I'm sure we'll be back on. Some
wonderful
postmodern polymath guys, they'll probably be on, and turn leftist guys will probably have on again. We're not saying them for sure, but any new people, new randoms, I was of the mindset, and this is just my opinion, and I'm curious to hear yours too, but I honestly think we should cool off on the guests for a while and just have it be us, you know, and even if we have to pick a topic to talk about instead of having a guest on, we can, you know, talk about it ourselves amongst ourselves.
That's another option, is because there's four of us. And so if there's only two main episodes and two After Darks, then we could definitely split it up and do his like more historical topics relevant to like what we want to talk about, or just an episode. Like if Tommy wants to
More Civil War, Nelson.
Yeah, I know. Tommy tells a story, Tyler wants to do something about whatever, Kai, et cetera, me, et cetera. We could bring on old hosts that we know are good, or we can just keep it in-house and do a historical thing from something that means well to us. Like I have episodes ready for the Southern Strategy and the Party Turn, Andersonville Prison. I want to get Chris, that really good public school teacher back from Louisiana, to talk about some stuff from New Orleans. Those are just three right off the bat, and that can be dragged out one a month. And so we could keep more stuff in-house, because we have a lot of episodes with a lot of guests that have spanned many, many, many different topics. But we also have our own opinions and our own things that we hold dear that we want to talk about. And because we really don't know what someone is going to say, because once you get a microphone in someone's face, it's all off. They think that they're fucking the next Chapo, and they say, or come down, they say whatever the fuck they want. So keeping it, I agree with Tommy about keeping stuff more in-house and bringing back old guests and possibly bringing on people that we know are not going to say some fuck shit. But yeah, no, I agree with Tommy about keeping it more with us, because I'm not going to lie, some of the best episodes, in my opinion, are the ones when it's just us, whether it's Kai telling a historical thing, Tommy talking about that Kellogg episode, or the fucking Tyler's. I cried, yo. I fucking lost my shit when Tyler talked about that fucking turkey. That shit was so goddamn funny. Fucking just his dad laying a 12 gauge across it. I fucking cried. I died. I fucking died. Oh, that was the funniest goddamn
story. I have something to say about that, actually. So when Tyler, when you told about that story about like hanging out the truck, shooting at the turkey or whatever, it reminded me of this thing that happened to a very similar thing that happened to me whenever I was a kid. I was probably like, I had to be 9 years old or 10 years old at the oldest. And my mother was very good friends with this guy, and I can't remember his name, doesn't really matter. But he had this like land out in New Mexico that we were hanging out at. And he was driving around like through grass, like not even on a dirt road on his land, like just through grass. And it was like the middle of the night, and he was like, there's a rabbit over there. And I was like, okay. And he's like, there's a pistol in the glove box. Will you hand it to me? And I was like, okay. So I hand him this pistol, and he's like driving through this fucking grass field with his headlights on. And he's like turning to use his headlights to see the rabbit. And then he just fucking sees the rabbit, and then with his lights, and then he just fucking like turns off to get the lights off of it and hangs out the driver's side and fucking shoots it. And I was like, there's no fucking way in hell you hit that rabbit. There's no goddamn way in hell. And he stops the car and he goes and picks up the fucking rabbit and throws it in the bed of the truck. And I was like, this is the most insane shit I've ever seen in my life. It was so fucking sick.
Wow. That's some John Wick shit. Like, what the fuck?
Well, no, so I guess why, he was why do you have like, an anti-student gun? Lights on it and you take the lights off, it was going to make the rabbit stop or something like that. I don't remember. This was like over... This was closer to 20 years ago, so.
But I remember being like younger, and I finally got invited on like this famous rabbit hunting trip that my dad went on every year.
Oh shit!
I thought I was gonna get to like hunt the rabbits. It turns out that I was the rabbit dog, and they dressed me up in really expensive briar gear, and they made me run through all these fucking thorn bushes.
Did they have game cameras?
No. No. Well, I think my dad does now, but growing up we didn't.
No.
Unfortunate.
So yeah. I had a, I'm sorry. No, go ahead. I'm sorry, Tyler. I thought you were.
No, go ahead. I'm done.
No. When y'all were saying about how it seemed to work a lot better with somebody who like knew their field, if y'all do, like when y'all do open up, I mean, there are like all kinds of people in like all the native governments, like the tribal governments around. That, I mean, I guarantee you, like, one phone call, you could probably get at least somebody interested in talking to y'all as a pre-interview. I don't know if it's a show, but.
Or a union rep.
Yeah.
A union rep, yeah. Yeah, we've done some union things in the past, and.
Yeah, we're big. Tommy and I are big, like, the unions love us.
God.
It worked real well for you last time.
Yeah, it worked real fucking well.
Yeah.
I got to wait for my driver. I was downgraded from friend the driver in like 5 seconds. That's great.
But I was.
That probably pissed them off worse to see a fucking white dude driving a black dude. Driver? What?
What the hell? That's when the dude looked at me and said, right. We're going to flip your car. We're going to burn your car. I was like, get the fuck out of here.
What kind of liberal shit is this?
I wish I had a gun.
I ain't no proletariat.
Mister, the funny thing is that Mr. Pink was there, and I looked over at him and I was like, oh, God damn it, these guys are going to get fucked. And luckily, his wife was like, calm down. And they left. And then Tommy and I got the fuck out of there because, yeah. Whoever's listening to that episode, that's just the tip of the iceberg. I could bring him back for like 3 or 4 more episodes and the shit will get just progressively fucking crazy.
God. But the one topic I would tell y'all, if y'all haven't heard about it, it's a Caldwell Massacre. I think I'm right on this. So I'll put it in the Discord. But basically, there is still to this day a monument that says 3 men fell in the defense of the cause of white supremacy. The words white supremacy are on the fucking statue. Like, it's on there. And it's across from a church. it's insane. And it's like one of those things where it's like, I'm surprised that there's like very few big name podcasts that have covered it at all on the left.
Oh, the Caldwell Massacre?
Yeah.
Okay. I'll take a look at it.
There's like a, it's a good I found thing a,
that statue is there so we can know about our history.
Yeah, exactly. I found a map of like a number of fucking riots that took place like from the end of Reconstruction to like the 1960s.
Yeah, Reconstruction is a good year.
It's crazy. Like there's one right down the road in Eufaula. There's a massacre there of people trying to vote, like black people trying to vote, and the Klan just showed up and was like, nope. There's a ton of stuff that like the more you dig into it, there's more about the South and the find than like what, you know, the Civil War. So, and even within the Civil War, there's more to it than just battles. Like, oh, we're going to talk about the Battle of Antietam. It's just like, that's boring. So it's, there's so much stuff. And I'm glad that people are finally like seeing that, like there's more of the South than just, you know, the negative stereotypes.
Famous general for having sex with a horse.
I love you. I love you, traveler.
It's actually unfortunate, you know, the fucking bug-eyed statue to Bedford Forrest, it got torn down.
Yeah, that was the good one. That's one I could have stood to keep standing.
Yeah, I almost got a picture of it, but we were going too fast. I couldn't get it.
I really hope that's how he looked.
Just like cockeyed. Really, his cockeyed cousin, the cockeyed cousin fucker that shot.
What are your thoughts? What would you change about the show?
What would I change about the show? Like, I think the general structure of it, as it is going right now, is pretty okay, right? Like, there obviously isn't anything actually wrong with Nelson, despite his Italianness, but... And I think, like, specifically in regards to... the episode that I recommended, like, what was it, Jews and anti-Semitism in the South, is that is specifically because it sort of required like a Jewish voice to speak for that, right? And I think I'm generally in agreement here, like pre-interviews and shit like that is pretty good.
I remember reading that form, and there's a professor I had that actually wrote a book about that. And I would love to get him on the podcast to talk about it. It's about it's In the Shadow of the Holocaust, Alabama's Jews, like during World War II, and how Jews in Alabama had to deal with one, like going over and fighting, two, the Holocaust, and three, Jim Crow, all at the same time. And it's a very good historical look at the radicalization and like how it all played in, how they felt about things going on, like the Holocaust and Jim Crow, and like, you know, Hitler and Germany is doing this to us, but then we get back fucking home, we're treated like shit too. It's a really, really good book, and I would love to have him on to talk about that specifically. Okay. I'm glad you brought that up.
Yeah, and I don't really know, like, specifically what I would want to change. Right, because that's because I don't really feel like that's my fucking place. It's your show. You can do whatever the fuck you want. But
we'll just make fun of you for it.
It's our show, Conrad.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's everybody's show.
That's the price you can pay, is that we can just completely make fun of you and mock you endlessly.
Just keeping you humble, friend. Nothing personal.
Okay, so anyway, y'all want to know what the first thing Tommy said to me when we were fucked up the other day? First off, he gave me way much more than I thought he was going to give me. So we're just literally colors are dancing, right? So it's fucking his ceiling. His ceiling looked like Christmas lights just fucking spinning around. And so, you know, I put my whole faith and trust in my friend for 15 years. I put my faith and trust in Tommy.
You should have known better.
I should have. But, you know, I'm trying to, after all these years, trust Tommy more. And so I did. I was like, you know what? I have no idea what the fuck I'm taking right now. I don't know how much of it is. I know that he fucking had it and it's his. So I'm just going to go with the flow, like Tommy always tells me to do. And somehow, by the grace of whatever the fuck deity is out there, it somehow ends up okay. No one dies. So
you had fun.
I did have fun. But you became a goddamn sleep band process. Listen, I already was. This okay. Made it better.
By the so way, anyway, the on. Dosage, was, it was 8 grams. I definitely told him it was going to be 4 grams. But
that's so much. Oh, my God. Yeah,
thanks. So the fucking ceiling looks like red, green, and white Christmas lights just dancing around. Then it goes to rainbows. And then the colors on the TV were like, whoa, dude, watching The Witcher is fucking wild. But I'm in the zone. I'm in the zone, right? I'm fucking, oh, I finally feel good after like however many months of just not feeling good. And I'm like, I'm just like sinking into Tommy's bed, which is actually very comfortable. And I'm just like, yeah, this is great. All of a sudden, out of the fucking blue, Tommy looks at me bug-eyed and says, he goes, do you want a seltzer? And I'm just like, what the fuck? Like, he just looked at me just bug-eyed, just like, you want a seltzer? I'm like, what the fuck, man? And I'm just like, that's basically what it sounded like. He just looked at me and smiled with his, I've never seen Tommy's eyes that big. Like, it's like, I just gave him $1 million and he just fucking stays like, do you want a seltzer? I'm like, what the fuck, dude? And I'm like, yeah, I want a seltzer.
That's great. Wait till we do an episode.
Tommy made me breakfast. It was like that print, the Chappelle Show episode with Prince, when he makes sweet pancakes. And then I listened to Greta Van
Fleet. Homemade from scratch.
And they were pumpkin spice. It was really good.
Fuck yeah. Yes. Fuck you, man. That sounds good.
It was fucking, and then for some reason, like, I don't know why I was fucked up. I was like, let's listen to Greta Van Fleet. And we were listening to music, and we put it on. It was in the middle of a fucking wave, and the fucking colors, and it just was like sounded, and I was just like zoned out completely. It's like having ADHD and being on mushrooms is fucking weirdest fucking thing. But like, fucking the colors and everything was wild. And then Tommy asked me if I wanted to have a seltzer, and it was just like, what the fuck? That was the first thing.
Maybe that should be an episode when all of you are fucking high.
Yes, yeah, we that is a plan.
Right, you know, God, it should be.
That is a plan. You don't want that episode.
No, it's all everyone but Ty is lying. Ty is going to keep you all wrangled in.
I know, deeper, it always happens.
The deeper I got into the that's so true. The deeper I got under the covers, the farther I felt like I was in hell. So then I had to get out of covers.
No bueno.
I said we all do an episode on heroin.
I'll be on for that one.
Did Tyler ever tell those stories? Kidding, no. Those stories are the fucking best.
Oh, those are the worst. God damn.
The apartment. Oh my God. That shit was so fucking funny.
A bar that I would go to just about every night after I got off work. We've all been in the service industry. You know, the bar you go to after work? It was that bar. So I get drunk there after work. And I was so happy because it was a Friday night and I had a Saturday off work, which was insane because I don't get Saturdays off work. That just doesn't happen, you know? Point is, I had the next day off work and I was like, I'm getting fucking drunk tonight. I'm going to get a lift home, all this. And the bar's like going to close in like 15 minutes or so. And the owner of the place that I work comes in and I was like, drunk as fuck. So I was excited to see him because he's all right. He's kind of crazy. He's this crazy dude, but he kind of took care of us really well. So it was it. And we take a shot, we get a little bit more drunk, and the bar closes. They kick us out. And he's like, so what are you going to do with the rest of your night? And I was like, kind of cool.
I mean, were you trying to like,
oh no. No, I was not trying to do that. That man is a crazy person. But I was going to drink free whiskey and let him pay for my ride home. So I go to his house. We drink a little bit of whiskey. We're hanging out. And this man says to me, and I quote, I'm going to pull the drugs out now. And I was like, the drugs? What does that mean? And I was thinking like, oh, he's probably going to want to do coke with me. And I don't want to do coke. I don't do coke. And so I was like,
awful.
And I was like, and I really don't want to do coke with him, even if I did. So like, I was like, man, this is about to be a really uncomfortable conversation because he's probably going to be bummed that I'm not going to do coke with him. And this man pulls out one of those gallon Ziploc bags full to the brim of mushrooms.
Yes.
And I was just like, oh, okay. You know, I tried mushrooms. I had like about 2 to 2.5 grams or so. And then right after we eat these mushrooms, we go back into his living room. And then he puts on Luke Cage on Netflix for me to watch. And I was like, I don't want to do this.
You let him take you to a second location. Yeah.
That's the Dahmer trap. I know. You got Dahmer.
I know. I'd been drunk at his apartment before, though, so it wasn't that weird. Because he went and laid down, and he had the lights off, and Luke Cage was playing, and it was like this matter of fact, like, oh, this is just not what I'm going to do. Thank you for the mushrooms. I'm going to go on a walk because I have to be outside. And he was like, okay. And so he comes out and gets the lights on. And so anyways, the point is I leave and I walk like 5 miles at like 4 a.m. back to my car. And it was so fucking fun. I had the absolute goddamn time of my life just running through the streets. And like my bike was like under this street light that was like shining on it. And I, at the time it was like angels were shining their lights down on my bike. And I was just like, my fucking, my bike. And so I was like, I forgot my bike was there. And so I went and unlocked it. And I ended up like zigzagging through the streets. I've just heard such terrible things about people's first time doing mushrooms. And I was like, I got to spend a lot of time alone and I really enjoyed it. So that's it. Honestly, that's my first mushroom story.
Honestly, I really don't see how people have bad trips. I have never, and I've been taking hallucinogens for years, and I've never once had a bad trip or been with someone who's had a bad trip.
Really? I think all my drug stories involve a doctor trying to give me enough benzos to get medical care without going unconscious with fear. So those, none of those are as fun as y'all's.
Yeah, like my first time smoking weed, it was like my entire body just locked up and I was unable to do anything. It was like a fucking war movie. Like everything was just fuzzy and distorted and shit. It was awful.
Get that catatonic chronic.
The opening scene, the Saving Private Ryan.
The only like first time drug story I've had that was like substantial and like sticks with me to this day was my first time fucking IVing Dilaudid. It was my first time ever IVing any kind of drug. And I just remember my first thought was like, all right, this is it for the rest of my life. It didn't pan out that way, but.
Well, that's good. I'll tell you the best hallucinogen I've ever had. And it was called 25i.
Yes, sir. The fake acid. That is the best shit.
Oh my God. Let me tell you. I'd heard about this stuff. But I had to wait to get it. Like only one guy in town. Like he would roll through every once in a while. And then one of my employees at GameStop, who was my connect, he was like, hey, man, I can get the stuff. And so I ordered like 10 hits of it. It was like $20 a hit. It was a lot. So, and me and all my friends, we got together one morning. And so, by the way, it was just liquid and no one knew how to take it. And these people that I got it from, they're like, yeah, you snort it. And I'm like, dude, I'm not snorting liquid. Are you insane? Like, I'm not going to drown myself on this shit. And so anyway, we decided to do it just like acid and just put it under our tongue, just let it sit there for as long as we could without swallowing it. Well, we ended up swallowing it anyway. But oh my God, let me tell you, like, I've done a lot of mushrooms and a lot of acid before, but I've never actually hallucinated until I took this stuff. And this shit was wild. And we ate so much fucking food. Like we ate, like we took like 2 trips to Burger King, and like both times the Burger King people like laughed at us because we looked visibly high, like as fuck. And I had no idea. And I was very upset that I looked that high. I was like, what? Like, what is wrong with me? Like, what am I doing?
That's so funny because that's like the exact opposite of how I felt whenever I was like literally running through the middle of the street at 4 a.m. Because I was like, if a cop rolls up, I can talk to the cops. I'll be fine. I can totally be like pretend to be sober to the cops. But I was like, I'm looking back. I'm like, I'm certain that that's not what would have happened. But at the time, I was just like, let a cop roll up. I can fucking talk to him. I got this.
For those of you who can't see
truly
the Zoom,
no sense of self-preservation.
For those of you that can't see the Zoom footage, Trey was a herding children away from our drug conversation.
Yeah, I was gonna say, I hope this isn't like just playing out loud. I saw a child.
Trey really is Brother William.
Yeah. Oh, and after we leave Burger King the second time, so I was driving a red Ford Focus. And I remember that
car.
And I had like four people piled in, and we're all just, you know, like just fucking high as shit. And I swear, so coming down the street was another red Ford Focus that looked just like my car. And I had like an existential crisis right then and there. Like,
did you do like the fucking Umbrella Academy thing with yourself?
Well,
y'all pass each other at the same time, look at each other.
Yeah, it was weird. Like, I looked at it and I was like, is that me? Am I doing that? Like, it was. It was crazy. I had a mental breakdown. Okay. So,
drugs are bad. Okay.
Everybody's cool with no guests or very, 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 very semi guests.
Selective. Very selective.
I think seldom guests will make them more fun when it happens.
Okay. So I'm
not on the guest Patreon, so it's clear what I'm here for.
So I have another question. So we dropped two hosts, we gained a host. Now, should we add another host, or should we keep it the way it is?
Who would it be?
Answer very carefully.
You could drop one more host, incredibly Italian host. So
I could corner the market on white on this podcast.
And I will say this: if we do add another host, it'll probably be a member of the LGBTQ+ community. So I will say that that's a possibility, not 100%, but that would be someone that we would add.
I think I think just depending on the circumstances or just depending on the context, I guess. I don't know, I guess depending on who it is, you know, it would be fine.
Yeah,
I think that'd be cool. I think it'd be cool to have.
I think y'all's schedules are so different.
Sorry.
Kat?
Oh, my apologies. I was saying it can't be something that you just like shoehorn into it. It's got to be something that like really just kind of meshes well with everybody.
Yeah. No, I agree.
I agree with that.
I think y'all's schedules are so different that it wouldn't get too crowded because there's always somebody missing anyways. Like you could rotate.
Yeah. Yeah.
Somebody said something.
Yeah, I agree with that.
What were you saying? Were you saying something, Ian?
Yeah, I was saying to offset the whiteness and the straightness, you need to add a bisexual Jew like myself.
I don't think they can put that in the help wanted classified.
Yes.
I feel like I need a prop since Nelson has props. So coyote, snake, raccoon, bobcat, or lamb?
Snakes. Snake. Mark, you have snakes, right?
I want to see a snack.
I don't have snakes.
I want to see you handle.
Wait,
the snake.
Are you asking which one we would eat?
No,
the one that Mark handles every Sunday.
What is that?
It's a snake skull.
What kind?
Oh, that's cool. Insane. It's a python. What kind of snake is that? Oh my god, that's so big.
Yeah, Mark knows. Mark is a snake priest. So
have y'all ever been snake hunting?
He knows all about the snakes.
I fucking hate snakes.
My cousin does that shit and he's fucking crazy.
Oh my god, it's awesome. You'd like,
he has no fear.
You go out to West Texas and you pump gasoline under the rocks so the fumes drive the snakes out.
We do the same with bleach. We do the same. I have to do this at my kids' playground every now and then.
And then you got to cut their heads off and separate the heads and the bodies in different buckets so you don't like get venom on your face and your skin.
Yeah.
My grandpa just shoot the fuck out of them. Shoot them with a single six.
You got to go to a rattlesnake roundup in like West Texas. If you ever
I would really love to do that, actually.
No, it was in West Texas. You would hunt rattlesnakes in West Texas with a single six, but we didn't do all that. But I've heard of that.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Sorry to interrupt. I'm going to be the pro boys.
Take it easy, man.
I don't know if y'all saw the two little ones there.
Trey
like,
has to be a parent.
I now have a face to memorize when I'm punching that punching bag I have outside. So now I know.
Yeah, hey.
Yeah. What is wrong with you? Why are you so mean?
Right?
So many things.
No, Nelson wants me. Man. Nelson wants my body, is really what it is.
It is. That's what it is. When he was
I'm a bottom. It's okay, baby.
I'm taking you. I'm taking you and Rain Dog out to the woods. This is the attention that I want.
You're gonna have some problems there.
Well, y'all have a good night, guys.
I will not go like
Inshallah, Brother William.
Inshallah, Brother William.
I have more things.
That's
going to be. You just make it go,
Mark. Say.
Hey, hold on. I can do it. Say something, Elsa. Wait.
Hey, Mark. Hi, Mark. My name's Scully.
My possum got hit by a car last week.
Oh, damn.
I don't have good taste in soda.
Mark is making an alligator talk. Oh,
thank you. Thank you so much.
For those of you in an audio format.
That was a coyote.
Oh.
Thank you for bringing up the fact that Nelson does not like root beer because he's a horrible
person. Fuck you, Nelson.
And then I have...
Yeah, he is, how are you... Damn, you talk a lot about being from the South and you don't like root beer.
I'm not a root beer fan. I'm not a root beer fan. Good.
What are your feelings on cheer wine?
On what?
Tell us now. Cheer wine.
I don't know. Excellent. I don't know about it.
Excellent. You never had cheer wine before?
Probably not.
Oh my
How can
God.
You call yourself?
Isn't that just like a different brand of Dr. Pepper?
Out, you Yankee
no.
I'm actually not in Alabama. Mm-hmm. I'm in Long Island. I never left.
No, by, no by,
my mom poser. Moved us here.
Nelson is a poser. Certified. This boy here is a carpetbagger.
I've got two.
What? Fucking, yeah. What the fuck did you just call me?
Larping.
Oh no.
All right. So,
if my grandfather hadn't gotten sick and died, I'd be in Italy right now. This is bullshit.
I've got a bobcat and a lamb as well.
Well, you're stuck here with that, Nelson.
Mark, what are your thoughts on adding a host? Should we add a host? Should we not add a host?
It depends.
It depends on...
I think we should clone Tyler and have another Tyler on.
Yeah, that's fine.
That might be too much.
That'd be hilarious.
Given that Mark is on again, off again, maybe he can be the host.
I'll infiltrate it from the inside for you guys. Don't worry.
Mark would be a good host.
Take it down.
Well, now I don't
would
know
I?
How I feel about
Mark. Mark would take it down.
Mark would help keep Nelson humble.
You either have to be a host on this show, you have to either be one, just batshit fucking crazy, or two...
Check,
buddy. Have you seen the Discord?
Yeah, you haven't seen the host group chat.
You just showed us your skull collection, but you're apparently not crazy enough.
I have two more that I didn't show you.
Host group chat. That was the wildest shit. The OG host group chat.
Oh my god.
To tell y'all think what I say is bad. Y'all think what y'all think is behind the elevator music is bad.
Buddy, when we stop recording, I work with nothing but Southern Baptists all day. I doubt y'all can say anything that I have.
We were a bunch of regular Nick Mullins.
Oh yeah. When we stop recording, we'll answer the real questions.
I mean, if y'all like me, and they, think like, because I can get social cues, so I go kind of getting that direction from that line of questioning. If people like me, I don't mind. But if I'm annoying, tell me so I don't ruin it.
Like Mark, I think I would thoroughly enjoy it if you were on the show, Mark.
And I will fight every single patient that comes in there and says bad things.
My only thing I would put in is, like, on the episodes that I have to miss, are you willing to go the places that I go?
I don't think I'm funny enough.
Are you willing?
They made me do the outro, and I don't think it was good at all. And they should really cut it out and clip it.
Oh yes, I am. I'm gonna put it at the end of this episode.
It's so bad. My voice cracks. It's like the most embarrassing.
Oh, I bet it's so cute. I bet it's cute.
What if I told you it gave me gender dysphoria? So if you put it in, it was
transphobic. Oh, that's not cute. That changes it. It's not cute then.
Yeah, Tommy, be careful what you wish for. You get the LGBTQ, you get the rainbow mafia after you.
Can it be a hate crime if Tommy's black though?
Also, I think it's also a hate crime that Nelson just said rainbow mafia. No one says that.
Yeah, yeah, no, it turns out that I'm pretty sure
it's in the group chat a number of times from all of us saying.
Like Nelson likes to have everybody think that I'm the closest to getting canceled, when in reality it's Nelson.
Yeah.
I think it's Nelson. Know, on top of his
like if anything, if I get canceled, it's like an like of mice and men situation.
Look at the fucking lake, Tyler. Tyler, come on. I need you to look at the lake, Tyler.
Oh my god.
But the only one who's close to a George in this situation is Kai.
Oh yeah, Kai's gonna be the one who just executes us all.
Kai gets first rights, let's be honest.
Yeah.
Bop, bop, bop. Oh man.
Kai
should just come back to the U.S. specifically to take away Nelson's guns.
I thought you were going to say take away his life force. And I was like, oh, well.
No matter what, I'm going to protect Nelson at all costs because I've got to have a mortal enemy.
It's like the Joker and Batman.
I'm his Moriarty.
I'm Nelson's Batman.
Am I the fucking penguin?
No, Jason Todd is the Robin. Jason Todd was a Robin, right? And he turned into the I can't think of the guy's name.
Red Hood.
Yes.
Oh, and he's Red like, Hood's fuck that man rules. I'm killing everyone.
Yeah.
Everyone dies today.
Okay, nerds. Editing Tommy here. I just wanted to let you know we're about to talk about Spider-Man Home Alone. I don't know. It's not an A24 movie, so why the fuck would you care anyway? But we're not going to spoil it. It's okay. There's going to be no spoilers, so calm down. Just relax. Don't turn off the episode or skip next or whatever. Just relax, okay? Calm down. No spoilers. I promise. This is not a trick. Not getting Rick Rolled. Not getting poop sock. All right. So back to the show.
Spoilers. Does anyone want to see the new Spider-Man movie that hasn't seen it?
I've seen it twice. Yeah.
Spider-Man's behind.
I've seen it twice.
I'm not gonna fucking talk about the fucking Spider-Man. Go see it ASAP.
We're not gonna spoil it, but I am gonna say this. That movie was hot trash. I'll just say that.
What? I cried like fight me, Tyler. Fight me, Tyler. I cried 2 times during that shit.
Fuck.
Let me tell you the reason why you cried deserved it.
It's because you're Forrest Gump.
I just want everyone to know that I rarely ever do actually agree with Tommy, except on this point. The movie was trash.
Bro, fuck the both of y'all. Fuck the both of y'all. Like, I will lie.
It was a nostalgic cash grab.
It was.
And it worked. It got me.
No.
Nostalgic cash grab is fucking Toy Story 4, not this.
Yeah, and I cried during that shit too. I need something to take me back to being 8 years old. I need to feel that again every now and then. Like, fuck you.
Watch fucking reruns of 9/11 then.
No. Not everything has to be fucking Bush era political, Nelson.
I do not want to go back.
I just have some
No, that was my favorite show growing up.
Look, 9/11. I haven't seen it, but I agree with Tyler. It's okay for something to be.
Yeah, I love the actors in 9/11.
For something to be a cash grab, a nostalgic cash grab. I think it's okay for that to happen.
Thank you. I need to feel that feeling. That's why I watch superhero movies.
Sometimes you watch a movie and it's like, I know this is garbage, but I like it. And it makes me feel feelings, and I like the feelings it makes me feel.
So I was legit, like, emotionally invested in that shit. Like, so fuck.
Yeah.
Hold on, you're all terrible people. Nelson,
Tommy, you like fucking Midsommar. The fuck you.
Genuinely bad.
I like Midsommar.
I actually really want to see Midsommar. I haven't seen that yet.
It's really good.
Okay, I mean, if you like Whole Foods horror, go fucking watch it.
The Blood Eagle is with it.
Go watch
The Lighthouse. Whole Foods horror?
Lighthouse is so good.
Please don't get Tommy started on A24.
All your friend circle, you use Midsommar to go and judge them. Like, okay, what did you take away from the movie? If they're like, I want to join a cult because it's a true family. It's like, you are the fucking Nazi. I don't want to be friends with you anymore. Go away.
The same reason I won't watch A24 is the same reason I don't listen to Tame Impala. Oh, dude, both of those are great.
Sometimes you just need a woman to
cry,
not watching that shit
in such a way.
I'm with you, Tyler.
You feel it.
Like, if I'm gonna watch a horror movie, I'm gonna put in like the original Texas Chainsaw Massacre. or something that's just not, I don't want to fucking do some like white intellectual art project shit for a horror movie. Like, no, give me somebody with a knife or a fucking chainsaw wearing a fucking mask.
You need that psychological thriller.
And let me tell you. I see why.
I've dated too many people who are into that shit and just fucking, maybe it's just past trauma.
Hold on, Ian. One last point. One second, Ian. One last point. New Person, Same Old Mistakes is a fantastic song. Okay. Like, it is fantastic. Tame Impala, listen to it.
Also likes The Smiths and doesn't care that Morrissey's a piece of shit. So, like, I don't take his musical opinion.
Next episode, Tommy's going to talk about how good Death in June is.
Okay. What were you saying, Ian?
Yeah, I see. I was just going to say that I see why Chris called him Forrest Gump.
Tommy edited out a huge chunk of that, too.
It only works when Chris says it. Chris and I were going back and forth
with some zingers, and Tommy cut out about a good chunk of them.
You shouldn't have. Like, that's good banter.
No.
I enjoy Chris.
No, saying, no, that whole time when you were like, What was it? What was that dumb shit?
He called me a juggalo because I had a mustache.
No.
That was the Forrest Gump.
When you guys kept doing Lieutenant Dan.
I don't know if we cut. I don't know.
Lieutenant Dan. Yeah, you know that's something.
Lieutenant Dan. All right, shut up.
Hey, you know what?
That was a great Morrissey
impersonation for the future of the podcast. For the future of the podcast, you should not do the Lieutenant Dan thing ever again.
Thank you.
That's pretty fucking ableist. If I say so myself.
Tommy, like Zack Snyder, you should release the Lieutenant Dan cut.
it got to the point where Forrest Lieutenant Dan joined the Klan to stop Vietnamese fishermen.
No. Oh my fucking God, no.
Throwback to 1970s, 1980s, East Texas, Louisiana.
All right, Tommy, I got to ask you this then. How do you feel about the upcoming Batman movie?
I'll say this.
I think Robert Pattinson did a good job.
I'm very excited for it because I think Robert Pattinson is a fantastic actor. Okay.
I think it looks great.
I think Good Time is a great movie. If you haven't seen it, please watch it. I think Tenet was fantastic. If you haven't seen it, go watch it.
But look, I'll put it like this: for every comic book movie coming to movie theaters, that's one less fucking Michael Bay movie, and I'm fine with that.
Yeah,
Michael Bay.
If I see another scene of Martha's fucking pearls falling into the alleyway after they've been shot to death, I'm gonna shoot myself, so I can never have to see that scene.
What I want to see instead of the pearls, I want to see the bullet go straight through her head.
If Nelson keeps burping, I'm gonna have to show him up.
What? Anyway. What? Do it.
That'll be a change.
I'm here sticking my finger in my belly button and burping.
Something new. I'm just tired of seeing the Waynes die in a fucking alleyway. We all know what happens. We all know what to expect. I want to see a genuinely good Batman movie. If not a genuinely good one, I want to see one that's so fucking bad that all the people who hate Robert Pattinson for playing Batman die of a coronary in the middle of the fucking theater.
Kat, how do you call yourself a leftist and not like that the Waynes get fucking murdered?
Yeah, I love seeing rich people die.
Yeah,
it's not that. I don't like it. It's not that I don't like it. I'm tired of seeing it. How many fucking Batman movies have we seen where the fucking Waynes die in a goddamn alleyway in the same exact way because no fucking director has come up with a fucking original idea for that goddamn series?
What would be an original way for them to die?
I will say this. Okay. And I need everybody to calm down.
I'll be right back.
I'm going to speak some truth. But anything Christopher Nolan touches is gold. And all of his Batman movies were gold. True.
You guys weren't allowed to watch them. They were too violent.
What? That man doesn't kill.
It's specifically not violent. He doesn't kill.
Yeah.
He just like brutalizes you and leaves you to, you know, deal with that in the street.
I know that's the worst asylum ever known to man.
Like rubber bullets. Rubber bullets don't kill.
Right? DC is ass. DC is straight fucking ass. Their movies suck.
I have an idea. But
for an original depiction of the Wayne's murders.
Christopher Nolan.
Yeah, I mean, but to me, out of his Batman shit, Dark Knight Rises is the best. It was better than fucking...
Oh, like, I love The Dark Knight Rises. People shit on Bane all day, but that movie was...
Bane was tight as fuck.
I think that was a good movie.
I think I've actually seen that one.
I think that was good.
Like, the voice thing and everything, it was sick.
I was fighting in the darkness, DC. But I was born in it.
I always thought I really hated like the DC universe until I watched like a lot of DC universe stuff that wasn't specifically centered around Batman. Like, I really thought Birds of Prey was cool. I really liked Birds of Prey.
My favorite thing about Birds of Prey is that they put their hair in a ponytail in a fight scene.
Oh, dude. Yeah, I've
been waiting for that.
Look, the best thing about Birds of Prey is like when the credits started rolling. That was...
Oh my god.
Like y'all are gonna shit on me, but god, fuck, I hate you. Quinn. I hate Harley Quinn.
You hate what?
I hate
Quinn. I thought I hated Harley Quinn too. Until I was like, oh, I hate this specific iteration of Harley Quinn.
Yeah.
But then I watched the Harley Quinn show where she like I don't want to spoil
on,
it.
On HBO
I
watched Max. The Harley Quinn show
fucking
gold.
That's fucking good, right? Yeah. Okay, so thank you. So I watched that and I was like, oh, maybe I like the DC universe. I just hate Batman because he's a fucking cop.
But I just hate.
Do you hate Harley Quinn? Do you hate the version of Harley Quinn that seems to the male gaze?
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. Is that I was like, oh, I don't like DC. This is all garbage. And then I saw a bunch of DC stuff that I specifically liked, and I was like, oh, this is just a shitty iteration of Harley Quinn. Harley Quinn is objectively sick. This is just a shithole version of Harley Quinn that some dumbass wrote. I don't know who wrote it.
The thing that I hate is that like upper middle class white girls have turned Harley Quinn into the new manic pixie dream girl shit. Like, that's so fucking annoying. Like, god damn it. Like, I had to go through this shit in middle school with fucking Garden State. Now I got to go through it with fucking
Squad.
Yeah. You got either Harley Quinn girls or you got Crystal Mommies. It's just, it's so hard. It's so hard.
Crystal Mommies?
Crystal Mommies.
I mean, yeah, I
what kind of Crystal Mommies are you talking about?
Garden State. I'm talking about the Harley ones Quinn, that have crystals. That's a great point. I know one of you in this chat has some crystals.
Somebody. You want me to show and tell my crystals?
I knew it.
I knew one of you was a crystal mommy.
There is a strong
difference
between liking crystals and thinking they're cool and thinking they can cure cancer. And if you're in the group that thinks crystals can cure cancer, I hope you die by fucking crystal to the head.
See, the only crystals I've ever been one. With that would they would like oh. inhale them and they would,
yeah, same.
They would think they're like bulletproof and they would go like rob gas stations and shit.
That's for your heart chakra.
I know some crystal.
I remember
like,
there.
I've dated some crystal mommies like that too.
No.
Yeah, I had a regular at AT&T. I had a regular at AT&T. This dude, he would come in with like 40 fucking crystals dangling around his neck, and he would have like a pouch, and like he would just like hold one and just talk to himself. I was like, just classic crystal mommy.
I have a question. How did you have a regular at AT&T? Why was he there so regularly? Why would anybody be at AT&T regularly?
I had regulars. I did have regulars. People
really? Because it's like I've worked in retail before in a place where it was normal to have regulars. But like,
No.
How often does somebody need to go to an AT&T store?
Oh, because people don't realize that you can pay your bill like on your phone. That they just spent.
People just went in to pay their bill regularly?
I'd rather die than go into a phone store.
That does not surprise
I'm a dumbass and I don't know how to use technology and I don't do that shit. Jesus.
Have you ever met older Gen X young boomers?
Yep, that's just
what
the
word yeah. in general. Okay. Yeah, yep. That's fair. That's fair.
He's a Gen X hippie. Awful.
I got home from work and my mom left me a paper bag full of styrofoam cups in front of my door. I'm like, do boomers just gradually lose their minds like every fucking year? It's the lead poisoning. I swear to God, it's the fucking lead poisoning.
I'm with you, Nelson, on that. I'm really fully with you on that. And I don't think that that is something that's discussed enough. But I do think that plays a bigger role in our society today in America than is discussed.
It's the fucking lead poisoning. Everything wrong with boomers can be traced back to the amount of lead they had in their life.
But what's the problem with lead
poisoning? I had a conversation at work today is that the people that I get the most fucking like shitty behavior from are from like like 52 to 65 age group are the fucking worst. I understand entitled school behavior. It's not just limited to one age group, but that is the age group where it's like the just we had a patient write a three-page letter to the doctor because she didn't smile at her. Mind you, this is during COVID when we're all wearing masks. How the fuck can we smile at you? And she wrote a 3-page paper about it.
Fucking Gen Xers are the worst.
I agree.
But they're the latchkey kids, so they're special.
God, if you just skip one person in line at the clinic I work at, they will come up there and like almost like shake the plexiglass and be like, why did I get skipped?
Oh, I had one throw up hands and walk out today like fucking total bitch fit because he arrived at his appointment late.
Well, Gen X has grew up with the worst group of music. Like, can you imagine how you feel that you grew up with
definitely the problem?
Nirvana?
Yeah, I listened to Pearl Jam.
I was about to say Nirvana, holy shit.
God damn. Like, fucking Nirvana is the worst fucking ass band I've ever fucking heard. Like, god damn.
I think it's going to be because they were raised off fucking like Beavis and Butthead in South Park and they're just nihilistic and
shitty. Whoa.
Beavis and Butthead is kind of cool, though.
Whoa.
Canceled all of you.
I want to say,
I have a question for Tyler. I feel like this is going to play a big role. Do you like South Park?
Yes, of course.
I love South Park.
Okay, time out. We were talking about this the other day, how like on TikTok, there's Zoomers that like will post videos of like high school back in like 2005. And they're like, oh, man, going to high school in 2005 must have been so cool. No, it fucking wasn't. No, it fucking wasn't.
Our whole entire JV football team almost got arrested because they sexually assaulted 5 other people. Yeah. No, it fucking wasn't.
It was. Yeah. Oh, it wasn't.
Half our football team died the year they graduated. So cocaine overdoses.
Oh, man.
You guys might have heard about this, about my high school. I have a thing to say about my high school. Oh, fuck it. I don't care. I already told y'all I'm from Texas, so fuck it. So whenever I was in, I think I must have been in 10th grade. So this was 2010. 11 or so, the baseball team of my high school sacrificed a chicken on home plate and so that they could win state or some shit like that. But they like basically like took a chicken from one of their yards and took it out onto home plate and did this like satanic, or I guess what they imagined was like some kind of crazy satanic sacrifice of this chicken. And then the next day when they were supposed to like have some big baseball game that they were sacrificing a chicken for, everybody got there and there was a fucking like ton of blood and a dead chicken on like home plate.
That's so cool.
And that shit made like international news. Like this shit.
That was like Texas.
Articles from Australia.
The Christian Friday's like,
I'm going to ask you a question and I want you to answer it sincerely.
Yeah. Oh,
on a scale of 1 to 10, how white were these people?
Oh, all white. 10 out of 10. All of them are white.
It's a high school baseball.
No.
It's high school baseball.
The high school baseball team in Texas. Do you think they, look, I mean, I'm not saying they didn't specifically allow black people on the team or anything like that, but you know.
It's a Texas football.
There weren't any, so.
Yeah, you know.
So, yeah.
Tyler did that at his high school with a pig. Like,
you know, high school baseball teams in the South. It's the same racial composition, even probably less so than fucking lacrosse, but still pretty fucking white.
Lacrosse? There's not lacrosse in the South. You guys have lacrosse? Anyone?
Yeah. Like there's one ritzy private school.
I'm gonna be honest. Like I don't even know what that shit is. Maybe. So
isn't that really, the shirt with the alligator on it?
I didn't know what lacrosse was until I went to New York, and all the kids had lacrosse things. Like, what the fuck's lacrosse? Then I found out it's an indigenous sport and it has a history and white people took it over and colonized it, but like fucking I don't know. There's one really fancy ritzy private school here that has a lacrosse team, and that was it.
A Christian studies
MA?
MA has a lacrosse team. Sacrificed an owl in the basement of a church.
Wait, what'd you say?
The Christian studies majors at my college sacrificed an owl in the basement of a church.
That's a Wait, time out.
What is a Christian studies? What is that? What kind of college did you go to?
I went to a Baptist
Did you go to Liberty University?
Basically, I went to Howard Payne University in Brownwood, Texas.
Woo!
And they had a chlamydia outbreak because they confiscated condoms. And then the Christian studies majors executed a sacrifice that reminds me ritual in the basement of a church with a great horned owl.
That reminds me of like the fucking Brigham Young University, you know, the Mormon school where they
had an outbreak, we got expelled if you had sex too.
They had an outbreak of anal gonorrhea because of the loop around.
The loop around?
What?
You're still a virgin. Yeah, it doesn't count.
Oh, yeah. That's the loop around. Oh.
Wait, what's
see,
the loop
I
around?
Didn't go to college, so I didn't get any of this wonderful experiences of like anal gonorrhea and sacrificial owls.
Yeah.
No, that's just at the Christian colleges.
Yeah, I just went to a community college, so I learned how to buy drugs.
That's where you learned how to buy drugs?
That's how I learned how to buy drugs at a like a higher echelon.
Yeah.
I learned how to palm drugs at home.
The neighborhood that my middle school and high school is on is called Methlehem. So that's pretty self-explanatory.
Not bad. Mark, where are you from again, if you don't mind me asking?
I live on the outskirts of Rome, Georgia.
Okay.
Do you know?
Interesting. No, I don't know anything about that. No, not really. I'm aware of Rome, Georgia because of the John Prine song.
That's but, the only way. That's the only place where he is legally allowed to practice being a snake priest.
I will name some bad things.
Yeah, that's how I know about Rome, Georgia.
The guys. We had a Klan rally on the front lawn of the Rome police office in 2016.
Ooh, checks out.
And then that.
How many people were there?
Oh, so many.
Oh, okay.
Why you need 30-round magazines?
Okay. The guys.
Were you at the front
the...
of the crowd, or were you at the back of the crowd?
I was working at Chick-fil-A then. Thank you very much.
Uh-huh. Oh, so, you were feeding the crowd. Oh, okay.
I didn't see these people
like
yet. Take the day off.
Right.
Sundays and clan rallies.
The guys that were in the Ahmaud Arbery case were there. There's like photographic evidence that they were there on that day.
I'm sure.
So that's fun.
Yeah, I was going to say, is anybody here surprised by that? Or
what's the name of
at your Chick-fil-A?
No, they were at the Klan rally.
Probably.
Oh, they were at the Klan rally.
Mm-hmm.
That you were in the front or back of?
Across the street. Sorry, but.
Okay, that's right.
It's not pictured. And then what else?
The base.
Yeah. Like a big group of those 3%ers, I think that's what they're called, right? There. And Marjorie Taylor Greene moved from Alpharetta, I think she's from Alpharetta, to Rome so that she could be in our district. And that's just, yeah. Oh, and there's a big racist cake.
Yes.
If you guys Google later, Honeymoon Bakery. They won the Food Network Holiday Challenge this year with a mammy cake, basically, is what it was.
I'm sorry. Wait, pause. They won?
Yeah, they won.
Here?
Oh, and there was black.
Mark,
fucking
won? There were black judges.
I shouldn't be surprised, but Jesus Christ.
Mark sent me the video and everything. Like, I watched. Yeah. Yeah. And Mark said it tasted great, though.
So. Right. I have not gone in there. Okay. I wanted to go in there and take a picture of the cake in person, but I couldn't.
So to kind of give you guys a general idea of like where I'm at, do you remember, I think it was on Twitter there for a little bit, did you all see the picture of the guy who had one arm, who was like flinging around a whip with like some Trump flags behind him?
What?
No.
He had one arm? I don't think I
remember
that.
He had one arm, Mr. Stumpy. He had, so we had a Black Lives Matter vigil last year here on my main street in Town Square, and right after it got done, this, you know, lovely individual, like poster child of, you know, just of society, shows up there, one hand because he lost it while he says playing with fireworks. He actually was trying to make a pipe bomb with a whip, like full-on whip. And he has his shirt off so he can show off his SS bars on his stomach.
Hell yeah.
just slinging around the whip and everything like that. And he's got his Trump 2020, you know, flags, everything behind him.
Hell yeah, brother.
He's putting on that huge spectacle and whatnot. Sheriffs, of course, are off to the side, letting him do his thing for a few minutes so he can have his, you know, time in the spotlight, because the sheriffs. Yeah.
They're having a Chick-fil-A
break. That's where I'm at, where we have guys with SS bars and whips on Main Street, like just whipping it around, and guys with bulletproof vests and AKs protecting the Confederate statue on that same Main Street corner, which is tended to by the Daughters of Confederacy.
Yeah, we had a, it's Robert Bedford Forrest, right? Nathan. Just so I don't sound stupid.
Nathan.
Nathan, whatever. He's dead.
Who cares?
Yeah, fuck him.
We had a statue of him.
We forget his name.
Right. We had a statue of him at Myrtle Hill Cemetery, is the big famous one. And it's facing, okay. So it's like this big hill in the middle of downtown Rome. And it was facing South Rome, which is predominantly Black and Hispanic, which I'm sure was on purpose. And then we have, there's another fascist thing we have. Besides people just going around with, they'll have swastikas all over stuff all the time. I might be misquoting what this is called, so if I sound stupid, I'm sorry. The Capeltine Wolf, I think that's what it's called. It's the wolf that's like breastfeeding like the babies.
Oh, the ones from Rome.
Oh yeah, the ones from
Romulus and Remus. Yeah,
yeah, it's a replica of that.
Oh, that's the cover of That Art Is Murder. Oh, dude, that's a dope ass album.
Gifted to Rome by Mussolini, I believe. So there's just all these great things about where I live.
There's a
also I live in the same district as Madison Cawthorn. Kill me.
Oh, my home district is Louis Gohmert. If you've ever had the displeasure of listening to that congressman speak for more than 3 minutes. Man.
I love Louis.
My fucking congressman is this fucking dork. This dorky, like 5'3" motherfucker.
I've got an inch on him. He's already lost.
He's already lost.
Ours is Barry Moore. He's a fucking rap sheet because his dumbass in the fucking Alabama Republicans decided to pass anti-corruption laws and then got fucking caught because of their own anti-corruption laws. And he got arrested. And I think he pled guilty and like ratted on Hubbard, the fucking former speaker of the Alabama House. And now he's our fucking congressman. Because the election was between Barry Moore and some dude who owned this like furniture moving company who fucking cheated the federal government and said that his trucks weighed more when he was fucking moving military families from base to base. And he fucking oversold the trucks and took money from the federal government. And he lost the dude with a fucking felony.
Man, really feels like fucking Alabama in particular gets a lot of those fucking times. Like, wasn't one of your old governors there basically arrested on trumped up bullshit charges? Like, who was that guy? Spiegelman?
It was Spiegelman. Yes, so yeah. Don Spiegelman was the last Democratic governor in Alabama.
Oh, yeah.
And one, he basically had the election stolen from him by like Bush's cronies and Karl Rove.
Yeah.
And then they fucking arrested him on like trumped up corruption charges, and he was sitting in like federal prison for years in New Orleans.
So
he
finally got out. I actually have a story about this. So I used to work at I'm not going to say anything specific. Well, I don't care. So I used to work at a vet, and and the doctor was married to like somebody related to Don. I think like his sister or something. I don't know. But all I know is, like, when they were doing phone taps, they also tapped our office's phones. shit was wild. And he had to go to court and for, like, 2 weeks, and it was wild. Yeah, yeah.
John, I think I would like to say that.
Huh?
Go ahead.
I would say the North Carolina is also home to Mark Meadows.
Mark Meadows.
Yeah, you know.
You're welcome.
And fucking, sorry.
No, you're good, Ian. What are you saying?
And then fucking Louisiana, we have that fucking Q-tip comp, Clay Higgins.
Clay Higgins.
Mm. You've never heard of fucking Clay Higgins?
No.
I have not.
He has the most ridiculous fucking accent. Like, you know the regular Cajun accent is kind of goofy already. He has the most ridiculous fucking Cajun accent ever. And the motherfucker filmed this campaign ad crying about what basically amounts to cancel culture and how, fucking conservatives are all oppressed and that regular bullshit. He films this fucking campaign ad bitching about that shit in front of fucking Auschwitz.
Oh, no.
I
did not foresee that ending.
Me either.
I did not see that coming at all.
If there ever was one.
I was like, yeah, okay, conservatives bitching about cancel culture and then what?
In front of Auschwitz.
And Frank, the most canceled on the planet.
Yeah, you know, he films it in front of fucking Auschwitz.
Jesus Christ.
Well,
and he's and of course he's like this comp wife beater and that regular sort of bullshit.
Well, on that note,
yes, on that note,
we've been going for about 2 hours. So, does anyone else have any final thoughts about the show? Anything they want to say before Tyler's got to put some kids to bed? I'm tired and fucking. We all probably got to work tomorrow.
I'm just genuinely surprised to be here. Thank you.
Thank you all for being here.
I hate all of you. Yeah, I hate you too, but I'm very happy to be here.
Thank you.
But
yeah, you know, it's it was very fucking fun.
Wait,
Mark, did Mark ready to do the outro?
Yeah, Mark has to redeem himself.
Mark, you gotta do the outro.
The funny person already said it.
No, you gotta do it. You got
I have an idea, Mark. Guys. Mark. We can all say it.
I will leave Zoom.
Mark, we can do it in unison.
Okay.
Ready?
Mark. Let's go, Mark.
You lead.
All right.
Good luck.
You have to go in
and the creek don't rise.
We'll see you
next time.
Woo!
Thank you, guys.
Yeah.
Good night.
Thank you.
Night.